Welcome back to part four of our tour around Scotland. In previous parts, you've seen that we've had three amazing days riding so far. Yesterday, we came back over the Sky Bridge and conquered the Balach na Bar. I wonder what today has got in store for us.
Last night, we had a lovely hotel at Pooleu. It's got some great views looking out over Lochu.
And ready to go after a hearty breakfast at Poolwee Hotel. The weather is a tad changeable, so fingers crossed for a dry day, but at least we woke up this morning to a lovely rainbow.
It's only 8 miles up the road for us this morning before our first stop. Yes, you guessed it, it's for petrol. Stopping at Lade General Merchants Post Office and Galena filling station so we can all fill up. We've got 94 miles in total to do today. We're in store for some more waterfalls, some more beaches, a nice old castle ruin, and a geographical site to look forward to along the way. I must say, this scenery along the first and second coast is all very dramatic. Lots of cliff faces and there's some bikers there in the lay-by giving us a wave. I must say, everybody's all been very pleasant so far along the trip. Let's just hope we can make it 50 miles to Ullapool for lunch without getting too wet.
Next stop was at Grunard Beach, but as you can see, the weather is a bit miserable, so we all decided to give it a swerve and make tracks. Another stop, Little Loch Broom viewpoint. It's time to give our legs a bit of a stretch, soak up the scenery and take a couple of snaps. getting towards the end of the A832 now, and another breathtaking viewpoint at Corrishalloch, and in the distance there you can see Loch Broome. Next stop, and it's only 400 yards down the road, it's the Corrishalloch Nature Reserve. Now, I'm not normally a person to be interested in nature reserves, but this one at Corrishalloch is a little bit special and well worth a visit. You walk over a swinging pedestrian suspension bridge to get a closer look at the Falls of Mesac. It's a 150-foot waterfall on one side of the bridge and a 200-foot drop into a mile-long gorge on the other side. It's not one for the faint-hearted, but definitely worth a visit.
Oh, my knees are knocking on that bridge. Ooh la la. You wouldn't want to drop anything down there, would you? Now we're back on the road with the GoPro strapped to the back of Big Steve's scoop. Get some good shots from this. There goes Martin on his T5. Giovanni on his Primavera. And Dawn on the Primavera. Will on his V100. Is that a thumbs up from Fingers? Pistol Pete on his PX. Stella Steve on his fuel injected Lambretta. There's Anna. And there's the last of the riders, Stewie Arden on his trusty PX200. And right at the back there, looking after us all week, doing a fantastic job, is Frank. Number one backup driver. Made it to Ullapool, didn't get too wet. In fact, the sun's out now. Must be time for a cheeky pint in the sunshine.
Time for a bit of lunch. Found a nice little place in Ullapool called the Arch Inn.
Is there a shop anywhere? Like a little test? About what?
Dawn's walk down there.
Ullapool's a lovely little fishing port, very picturesque, and I had a nice stroll around the village before it was time to fuel up with petrol and crack on.
Joining us 13 miles north of Ullapool. First of the main two stop-offs this afternoon is the geological site of interest called Knock and Crag. short walk up the hill to the main exhibition area. It's a little structure called the Rock Room. Once you're in the Rock Room, you can find various displays and interactive models. They all help explain the landscape around us and the local geology. In the Rock Room, there are some quirky Perspex mountain silhouettes arranged around the perimeter, so you can relate to which mountain is which, and it helps to give you the big picture of the surrounding landscape. It's all quite fascinating and very informative. It explains how the different rock surfaces were pushed on top of each other due to tectonic action when two continents collided here 3 billion years ago.
Crew went over to take a closer look at the old Ardvoret castle ruins, and some of us just chilled out and were looking forward to getting to our accommodation that night in Loch Inver. Ardvoret castle dates back to the late 1500s, and over the years it was fought over many times in a long-running feud between the MacLeods and the Mackenzies. The castle is probably the most famous for being the place where the royalist, the Marquis of Montrose, was imprisoned after he'd lost the Battle of Carbisdale. He was strung to a horse and was carried 230 miles to Edinburgh for execution, where his body was dismembered and parts were displayed in public across Scotland.
Okay, we're a little bit ahead of schedule getting to Loch Inver for the night. We've got a bit of time on our side, we've got the weather on our side. Good opportunity to try and track down the Wailing Widow Waterfalls. Found them. It's a real hidden little gem, this one. It's off the A894, halfway between Loch Assynt and Carlscoe Bridge. Little parking spot on the main road, and about a 300 yard walk over some rough terrain to get to. But trust me, it's certainly worth the effort. As it overflows from Loch Nagamich, the water drops 15 metres before it flows off down the burn. Time for a couple of photos and the obligatory selfie. Now it's just 5 miles to our digs for the night in Loch Inver.
Okay, here we are. We arrived in Loch Inver, where we can see the deer on the football pitch. These deer are the famous deer of the Scottish Highlands. As you can see, they're on the football pitch in the newspaper. Steve ran out to have a game of football with them, and it went quite successful. As you can see, they're all having a quick kick about. Steve fouled one deer, which is now on the floor, not looking too happy. As you can see, again, the deer playing football. He's just scored a couple of goals, looking very proud. And there we are. Full-time score, Stella Steve 1, the Deer 3.
Well, that was another great day's riding. 95 miles from Paulu up to Loch Inver. That brings us to the end of part 4. Look out for the next instalment. We get to go to the beach tomorrow and check out a remote lighthouse before we get to ride the infamous Drumbeg Road. Then we get to cross the iconic Carlscoe Bridge and we're on to Durness. Look out for part 5 of our Scotland tour, coming soon.